Father Zakaria Botros is perhaps the most hated man in the Middle East. He's confronting Islam with an in-your-face style of television and internet evangelism.
Muslims are fainting. They are brainwashed. They believe that Islam is the most beautiful religion in the world. You can't preach him gently about your beliefs because he rejects all of them. So, you have to awaken him. My method is a short, sharp shock, which means an electric shock.
A jolt that is leading Muslims to critically examine their own faith, says Father Z. Then they start posing questions to Islamic religious leaders. When they go unanswered, they begin to question their faith. Like this woman on a Middle East talk show. She asked her co-host Sheikh Jamal why Islam treats women as possessions to be used by men for sexual gratification. Basma says that part of her faith is hard to accept. Father Zakaria's weekly 90-minute television program, Truth Talk, airs Friday during prime time throughout the Middle East. It's broadcast on the Al Hayat satellite channel and is watched by nearly 60 million Arabs. Zakaria's internet discussion show, Pal Talk, is broadcast on the World Wide Web for 6 hours every Tuesday and Thursday. Zakaria recently celebrated his 75th birthday. He's faced many hardships and challenges during his life's journey. Perhaps the greatest affecting his spiritual walk was the tragic slaying of his older brother more than 60 years ago.
He was not only a Christian, but he was a believer, a true believer.
Zakaria says when his brother was in his 20s, he started to share Christ with anyone who would listen, Coptics and Muslims alike. He was murdered by Egypt's Muslim Brotherhood in 1947.
It was very powerful in those days, and they killed him. They cut his tongue and beheaded him. Yeah, it was very hard.
Zakaria was a teenager at the time. He inherited his brother's Bible and says the notes written on the pages inside helped him to know Christ. He thought good works would help him get into heaven. It wasn't until he studied the writings of Cyril, the 4th century bishop of Jerusalem, that he came to believe in redemption and salvation through grace. He fell on his knees and prayed.
Thank you, God. Because your blood, not my blood, that my sins are forgiven. Thank you. Thank you, God, for that. So it was a turning point in my spiritual life.
Zakaria walked into another kind of service, a ministry to Muslims. That led to imprisonment and eventual exile from Egypt in 1989. He started Pal Talk while living in England. And he began his television broadcasts in 2003. Today, he's in hiding. Al-Qaeda terrorists have placed a $60 million bounty on his head, and that has made him cautious but unafraid.
Because I believe that I am in the hands of God, and He protects me, there is no fear. Jesus said, "Don't fear." And there are about 366 promises in the Bible, don't fear. Where can I find the word fear? Where can I put it?
So Islam's public enemy number one presses on. And what if the day comes when a militant Muslim makes good on threats to end Zakaria's ministry?
People see the program on the TV, but I see the hand of God is working among all of them. In the heavenly TV, I see by faith, what's going doing among Muslims today? I will be so happy, you know? I'll be so happy to have my life ended on earth because I will start my eternal life with Jesus Christ, whom I love.